How's it going, everybody? I hope you're all enjoying the sun. I certainly am. I'm back at Pentra Plaza, up in Rhondda Valley in the hills now. I've been spending a lot of time in Swansea at the new Airbnb house, but, you know, people have been booking, people are in the house. I've got a good team of cleaners that are coming and going and sorting everything out. So I can kind of step away from it a little bit now. It's sort of under control. So there's someone in there tonight. There's someone in there tomorrow night. There's someone in there this weekend. So it's all good, really. I had a bit of a backlog of laundry because the washing machine broke down. So I had a bit of a build up that I hadn't really... But I've just been blasting through it. I've put up some washing lines in the garden of both of the houses. So I've got, you know, more of a system going now. Maureen over the road's doing ironing for me. And, you know, I've got a nice little system worked out. So, yeah, I've got loads hanging up in the garden now. And, yeah, I'm just sort of, yeah, things are kind of in order now. Busy, lots going on. I'm looking forward to going to Soul Tribe this weekend. It's a small festival, a kind of alternative, new age, off-grid type of thing. Tribal, shamanic, all of that, all the kind of stuff I'm into. So that's in North Wales at Spirit Horse, which I've never been to. It's some kind of off-grid community event space type of thing. Where they have, you know, retreats and gatherings and I don't know, really. I mean, I presume they grow food. So it's great. You know, there's loads of these kind of places that have been popping up more and more, which is really good to see. I try and keep track of it all. I sort of, you know, follow all the pages on Facebook and try and, you know, keep an eye on what's going on. There's loads. There is definitely loads of that kind of thing. So it's great. That's one of the good things about the last 2 or 3 years lockdown and all that. Everybody kind of really clarified their tribes and came together. You know, that's what Real Awake is as well. Real Awake's a result of that. It started off as housewarming parties just for people that were like-minded, and now it's become regular retreats several times a year. So yeah, it's good, really. It's nice connecting with people that you're on the same page with. So yeah, I'm very happy about that. So I'm looking forward to going up there this weekend. Yeah, can't wait. That'll be my first real event, like going away for a few days this year. I go to Ecstatic Dance, like, you know, once a month or a couple of times a month. So that's a nice little top up, but it's really nice to spend 2 or 3 nights with people, because then you can really, yeah, spend time, get to know people. It's just another level, isn't it? So, yeah. And then next weekend, I go to London to Synchronicity, where Yema are performing. So that's exciting. So that would be a good... I mean, going to London's a fucking pain in the ass, isn't it? I can't be bothered with that, really. But, you know, there we go. What can you do? I'm going up there. So I'm sure I'll see loads of familiar faces. And then the weekend after that, the last weekend of June, is Real Awake. It's my own event, my own retreat. And it's all organised. It's all sorted. We've got a good gang of people, 22 people booked, 3 places left. So, you know... Yeah, there's loads to look forward to, really. So that's it. And I bought some Crocs. I didn't buy some Crocs. I bought some cheap replicas. I kind of wish I bought some Crocs, because I think the plastic that these ones are made of is a little bit... I don't think they're quite as comfy. The plastic's a bit hard. So I was being a bit of a cheapskate, really. I should have got the real ones. They're fucking 35 quid, though, I think. Or more, maybe. And these ones were... half that. So yeah, I've been out for a run today, so I'm feeling pretty good. I might eat some magic mushrooms. Got a business meeting tomorrow, but yeah, I find that there's no hangover from magic mushrooms. It doesn't leave you feeling depleted or drained or tired. Well, it can leave you tired because it can keep you awake, so you end up... You can end up a bit sleep deprived if you have them too late, and then it'll keep you awake all night. The best time to do it is sort of in the afternoon, really, because by the time you're coming back out of it, it's sort of bedtime and you're ready to go to bed at a normal time in the evening and get a good night's sleep. So that's the least disruptive way of doing it. But I tend to not really worry too much about things like that, and I just eat them whenever I want. Yeah, so I don't know whether to save them for the weekend. I should save them for the weekend, really. Shall I save them for the weekend or eat them now? Don't know. I ought to save them for the weekend, really. I might just have a few. It is really nice because it's almost like getting the wheels balanced on your car. You know, when you take it into the garage and they change the tyres and balance the wheels, it sort of, I don't know, it balances your nervous system. It just makes a few connections and it brings some clarity and brings things into focus, and you sort of prioritise better and you stop caring about things that you shouldn't be worrying about, and, you know, it just sorts everything out. So it's worth doing, very worth doing. I'd quite happily eat them once a week, no problem. I'm not a microdoser, I'm a macrodoser. I'm a eat them all. Eat them all. Why not? What's the point in microdosing? I mean, okay, I do have the luxury. I do have a lot of free time on my hands. My time's very flexible, so I've got the time. If I want to, you know, just take the whole evening off and eat a load of mushrooms, I can, and there's no negative repercussions, thankfully, you know, because that's the way my lifestyle is. But if you've got a busy life of kids and other responsibilities, I can understand it might be tricky to do that, but that's just more of a time commitment, time availability kind of thing. In terms of the actual mushrooms and the trip itself, there's no practical reason not to do it. They're not bad for you. Arguably, they're very good for you in terms of psychology and all that. So sorry, let me turn my phone thingy off. So the bottom line is eat mushrooms all the time, as much as you can. That's really, is if I could get my hands on them more easily, more regularly, I'd certainly eat them more often. You know, it's just an availability thing, and they're quite expensive. You know, they're £10 a gram, which is, I don't know, you know, it adds up, doesn't it? It all adds up. I think that's it. That's all I can say, really. I got a new laptop this week. My computer did very well. It was a desktop Mac Mini. And I always used to have laptops, and then I switched to having a desktop, and I really liked it because I was always in the habit of carrying my laptop around everywhere, taking it to bed with me, and just, you know, just being on the computer too long, too late at night. And there was something really refreshing about just leaving the computer on the desktop and not being able to walk around with it. And I like that because then it's just a workstation and it's, you know, it doesn't follow you around. And that was fine. I did that for 10 years. And it was fine. And all I really need it for is video editing, which is quite, you know, it needs a lot of processing power, but everything else you can pretty much, you know, web browsing and all that, most of it you can just do on your phone, can't you? But I do need a laptop. Yeah, so but my lifestyle just became a bit more mobile recently, sort of going back and forth between two houses, and it was becoming tricky to move my desktop computer back and forth. It was just really inconvenient, and there was work I needed to do, you know, and I wasn't able to do it because and it was about time I got a new one anyway, so I've got a laptop and it's really good, and I'm looking at it now, so I'm pleased with that. So I sorted that out. Yeah, that's it. Anyway, I'll leave it to it, guys. Let me know how you're doing. I'll let you know how it goes with the washing. Thanks to those of you that advised about washing at 90 degrees for bedding for guests. Good shout. All right, everyone, enjoy the sun. Have a good day. Cheers.